Been recorded by George Strait and several other folks. It goes like this. I was on a bus coming back to us from Atlanta in 53. And I picked up a Rhythm and Blues magazine laying underneath my seat. That's a true story, Laka. I did pick up that magazine. Then I found out the stuff they were playing us was made from grits and bone. And it would take more than the crew cuts and Pat Boone to take me home. Cause I want the real thing. Work with me, Annie, the real thing. All night, lady, make it loud. Make you proud of the songs that they sing. Daddy had a baby under my roof with your 86 proof. Watered down, it tastes like tea. Gonna pull my string, make it the real thing. Turn that thing up, John, a little bit. And I remember old Elvis, when he forgot to remember to forget. And when young Johnny Cash hadn't seen the side of Big River yet. And when sun was more than the daylight shining on Memphis, Tennessee. Perkins was picking and playing them songs to me. And I want the real thing. Like Trina loves a leaving thing. Leaving my heart grieving. Don't it make you proud? Of the songs like everybody's baby, but mine's coming home. Don't want you under my roof with your 86 proof. Watered down, it tastes like tea. Gonna pull my string, make it the real thing for me. Here's a real thing, John, put that. And when sun was more than the daylight shining on Memphis, Tennessee. And Perkins was picking and playing them songs of me. I want the real thing. Like Trina loves leaving thing. Leaving my heart grieving. Don't it make you proud of the songs that they sing? Like Annie had a baby under my roof with your 86 proof. Watered down, it tastes like tea. Gonna pull my string, make it the real thing for me. You're gonna pull my string, make it the real thing for me. And I have a song that tells you why. There was a ukulele waiting under my seventh Christmas tree. Until then, I was a fiddler, but my brothers had enough of me. They said, oh, mommy, oh, daddy, if you could stop that screeching, it would sure make us happy. Merry Christmas. Oh, my bastard brothers. And from the ukulele to the guitar in my country high school band, well, we were signed to an all-black record label, just white boys pissing in the wind. I said, oh, mommy, oh, daddy, can't sell no records, but I sure am happy in the business. Oh, Merry Christmas. So I signed me a contract to write songs for others, to find me a way to get back at my brothers. If it wasn't for those slimy, sneaky mother jumpers, I could have been a train man, could have been a trucker. Put me on an oil rig south of Calcutta, or like Itzhak Perlman in Carnegie Hall. I could have had it all. If it wasn't for my bastard brothers.
I have to look faster, John.
boy said, stop that screeching. Can you imagine them doing that to me? Anyway, John every once in a while does a show with me. He gets on stage and he's very charming. He tells the story as he remembers it. And Mom passed away in 1995. She was very brave through illness, but she passed away then. And just before she did, about a week before she passed away, we were at the hospital, and the nurse came out and said, Barbara would like to see John and Barry. I'd like to talk to John and Barry. Not me, you know. I was very close to Mom. I felt a little slighted, but the boys went in and talked to Mom, and about 20 minutes or 25 minutes later, they came out, and John was like, you're not going to believe what Barbara just laid on us. What happened? He said, Mom told us that one of the biggest things that she regrets in her entire life was taking the fiddle away from you. And she holds us responsible for it. So I said, well, good. So I signed me a contract to write songs for others, to find me a way to get back at my brothers. If it wasn't for those slimy, sneaky mother jumpers, I could have been a train man, could have been a trucker, put me on an oil rig south of Calcutta, or like Itzhak Perlman in Carnegie Hall. I could have had it all if it wasn't for Barry Boyd and John Boyd, the bastard brothers. Hey, Johnny, did you feel that movie? Did you feel that movie? Did you feel that movie? Johnny, did you feel that movie? Ain't nothing stopping it now. Hey, Johnny, the floor was shaking. Did you feel it shaking? It was almost breaking. And hey, Johnny, did you feel that movie? Ain't nothing stopping it now. 1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock round clock tonight. When the clock strikes one, join me, hon, we're gonna have some fun. Gonna rock the ground and fly. Rock and roll, jump it. Crazy man, crazy, they were scared as hell. They were scared as hell, they were scared as hell. Crazy man, crazy, ain't no white boy music. Nothing's stopping it now. Well, they turn back to Comet in midstream. Turn back to Comet in midstream. They turn back to Comet, coming again. And nothing gonna stop it now. 1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock round clock tonight. When the clock strikes 2, 3, and 4, and the men fall down, we'll tell them all. Gonna rock. That tunnel, black and white, and they blast that tunnel. Black and white, it's a blackboard jungle. And ain't nothing stopping it now. And hey, Johnny, did you feel that movie? And hey, Johnny, did you feel that movie? Hey, Johnny, did you feel that movie? Ain't nothing stopping it now. I said 1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, on the rock. Round clock tonight, when the clock strikes 5, 6, and 7. Rock, rock, rock in the broad daylight. We're gonna rock, gonna rock in the red light. There'll be no strings to bind your hands. But if my love can't bind your heart, and there's no need to take a stand, it was I who chose to start. She said, I see no need to take me home. I'm old enough to face the dawn. Just call me angel of the morning, angel. Just touch my cheek before you leave me, baby. Just call me angel of the morning, angel. Then slowly turn away. The sun's light will be dimmed, and it won't matter anyhow. If morning's echo says we've sinned, honey, it was what we needed now. And if we're victims of the night, I won't be blinded by the light. Just call me angel of the morning, angel. Just touch my cheek before you leave me, baby. Just call me angel of the morning. Slowly turn away. No, I won't beg you to stay. Through the tears, baby, of the day. Just call me angel of the morning.
And I try, but I can't say goodbye. Know that it's wrong, I should be so strong. But the thought of you gone makes me want to hold on. Feel so bad, baby, oh, it hurts me. When I think about your love and desert me, I'm the broken-hearted toy you play with. Baby, baby, I need going. Honey, I can't let go. Turn my guitar up, keeps. No, I'm just one. put yourself on the mountain, put yourself on the mountain, I suppose. You won't come back till you find you a fox or a skunk gives you smelly clothes. And Johnny, go on, put yourself in the movies, put yourself in the movies, I suppose. Won't come back till you're up on the screen with the Hoffmans or Pacino. And late last night, Daddy's telling stories. He's the FBI and he's bound for glory. Danger on the docks, boys, don't you know? It took me 6 years to be sure he was a gun pro. Put yourself in the music, put yourself in the music, I suppose. No, you won't come back till you're up on the stage with the Louvin Brothers or some of those. And Barry left a note for Daddy. Said, I stole $10 from your pants. And me and Jamie gonna tuck a whole station, gonna give that old train a chance. Okay, this is the scenario. My brother Barry, at 8 years old, six. Barry's, when Dad and Mom went out for a little while in the afternoon, Barry stole $10 from my father's pants and convinced me to go for a ride on a train with him. An 8-year-old and a 6-year-old in the snow in November. And I didn't really want to go, but I felt bad for Barry because the dynamic in families are kind of funny. You know, I was the third, the baby. The grandparents probably weren't happy I was around at all. My mom wasn't supposed to have another kid. I was there. Barry was the spoiled one with the uncle and the grandparents. But for me, looking at Barry, I always felt sorry for him. He had to be with the grandparents. I wanted to be home with Mom and Dad or around the house, and I used to feel bad for Barry. Yeah, Barry was with the uncle. Why? I wouldn't want to go with the uncle. Funny stuff, family stuff, it's funny. So I really, honest to God, felt sorry for my brother Barry. If he asked me to do something, I was trying to say yes. Even though I did not want to go for a ride on a train, I said yes. And at 6 years old, I trudged down Ball Avenue, up Lockwood Avenue in a snowstorm like you wouldn't believe, across Miles Square Road, up Palmer Avenue to the train station with my brother Barry. And scared and not wanting to be there and freezing, and finally I said no, I wouldn't go for a ride in the train. Barry brought me into a little luncheonette store to calm me down. He thought I'd feel better if he bought me a chocolate malted, which we shared, and a hamburger. So, can you imagine him handed a $10 bill to the guy, 8 years old? And so finally I said, no, Barry, I'm not going to do it. So I was crying, and he said, okay, I'll tell you what, I'll take you home if you do one thing for me. There's a little mountain over here on the side, and it's not far from here. It'll take you no time, and I'll take you home. But there's a little cave that I can't fit in. You can fit in it. I'll hold your feet and put you down. You tell me what's down there. And if you do that for me, I'll take you home. I went up to the mountain, held my feet. I still was crying, and I get down there. There's nothing here, Barry. There's nothing here. All right, okay, I'll take you home. So we started down the mountain. As we came down the mountain, I see this police car coming down Palmer Road, and Barry saw it too. And Barry says, hop over the bushes, quick, hop over the bushes. So we hopped over the bushes, and we're laying there freezing in the snow. And I remember seeing this boot come right next to my eyes. And the police officer said, okay, boys, it's time to go home. And they took us in the police car, brought us home, and I remember
I remember Dad standing just as he opened the door to our house. Dad was standing off to the side. He always had this stance. He looked like this. That was my father. And he just stood there as the policeman lectured us, you know, saying that what bad boys were never to do it again. And Dad would just say, "Thank you, officer. Thank you. That's very good. Thank you, officer. Thank you." Finally, they left. And when they left, Dad said, "Boys, come here a second." He got us over in the corner. He said, "Now listen." He said, "Adventure is adventure." He said, "But geez, don't do that one again." And late last night, Daddy's telling stories. He's the FBI and he's bound for glory. Danger on the docks, boys, don't you know? It took me 6 years to be sure he was a golf pro. Now, Barry, go on, put yourself on the mountain, put yourself on the mountain, I suppose. Won't come back till you find you a fox or a skunk, you just smelly clothes. And Johnny, go on, put yourself in the movies, put yourself in the movies, I suppose. You won't come back till you're up on the screen with the Hoffmans or Pacinos. Here's a song that I had out in the Unglorious Hallelujah album. Is there solid ground with your family ties? Do you stick around when the hard days come? What do you say, son? I need some help with that. I need some help. I need some help with that. I need some help with that. I need some help. I need some help with that. And do you love your neighbor like you love that needle? Do you feel your savior flowing through your veins? And son, can you change? I need some help with that. I need some help. I need some help with that. I need some help with that. I need some help. Need some help with that. And I bear witness, I am ashamed, not of the fall, but of how I fell. And I bear witness, I'm naming names in the name of the Father. I need some help. Now look in the bottle. Is the devil in it? Do you feel a throttle? Can you stop at will? Does it own you still? I need some help with that. I need some help. I need some help with that. I need some help with that. I need some help. I need some help with that. I need some help with that. Some help with that. I need some help.
this love that you want. Baby, you got it. From the depths of my soul.
Jukebox that played all of them bad songs. Oh, what would I mentioned that Dad was a golf professional, and he got a nice little thing happen to him at one period of time. He was a head professional at Sunningdale Country Club in Scarsdale, New York. And one of the members said, "Elmer, I have a job for you in St. Croix. You're not going to make a lot of money, but they'll treat you real good." So in the wintertime, Dad and Mom went to St. Croix, where Dad taught golf, and they kind of basically got a little vacation. And that was really nice. And when I was a senior in high school, Dad and Mom were there, and my brothers were off at college. I decided I was going to have a party at my house. My folks' house. And I was just starting to get into horse race handicapping and betting, and I knew all these mafia guys, you know, around Westchester. And I told about 10 of them I was going to have a party at the house and asked them if they'd like to come. And then I asked a few more, and I said, "You can invite a friend, or you could invite a friend." And I expected maybe 10 or 12 people to show up. Well, when this party happened, and I had the local girls in the neighborhood serving the whiskey and the food, but we had to send out for more food because instead of 12, we had 50 cars in the neighborhood lined, Cadillacs all lined around the block. And it was a hell of a party. It was just great. It was mostly all the mafia guys. And I was trying to show them music, you know, what I liked in music, and I was playing them Elvis and Johnny Cash and stuff like that. And one of the guys was in the backyard, he started singing opera, you know, and it was great. It was a hell of a party. So they were polite, and they didn't ruin the house or anything like that, but they were there, and the neighbors knew it. And Mom and Dad came home a few days later, and Dad, about a day after he was home, he said, "Jamie, come here, I want to talk to you about something." I said, "Hey, Dad," he said, "I heard you had a party here." I said, "Yeah, I did, yeah." He said, "I heard there were Cadillacs lined up all around the neighborhood." I said, "Yep, that's true, Dad." He said, "I heard somebody was singing opera in the backyard." I said, "Yeah." He said, "Damn. I wish I could have been here. I wish I could have been a dreamer. Well, I guess it, I still am. A storytelling scheme. Who made him some big plans? Like getting all the bad guys to listen to all the good bands. Come over to my folks' house, to my barbecue slam jam, with Elvis on the box and opera on the other hand. Oh, what would I do without horses?" The bar where the last one out is a movie star and the first one, oh, I should tell you, the Pravda bar is in New York, not in Russia. Well, I met her there at the Pravda bar where the last, well, I should tell you something else too. It's in an album that we don't have for sale back here called 7 Days in May. Well, I met her there at the Pravda bar, where the last one out is a movie star, and the first one comes in a limousine. No one says much about nothing. And I saw her there at the top of the stairs, and when she left to comb her hair, I asked my bartender friend Ryan for a double scotch, whatever she was drinking. Joni, she's an angel sent from up above. And any damn, we had some golden days. And Florence, she's forbidden now, but I take her with me anyhow. In memories, those 7 days in May. Now, when I handed her the cassis and champagne, she said something in French I didn't understand. An acquaintance of hers said she's 5 months pregnant and she thanks you, but she's not drinking. So I got her some milk and we spoke for a while, and she spoke with her eyes and with her smile, and I didn't know French, she knew little English, but somehow it didn't matter. She's an angel sent from up above. And any damn, we had some golden days. And Florence, she's forbidden now, but I'd take her with me anyhow. In memories, those 7 days in May. I sit in Tennessee watching a cardinal out in a dogwood tree, playing amongst the brown birds outside the Country Music Hall of Fame. And I'm thinking I'm a lucky man, like the brown birds, I've been blessed again. Florence and the baby and Guillaume are fine, and that's the way it should be. Joey, she's an angel sent from up above. And any damn, we had some golden days. And Florence, she's forbidden now, but I take her with me anyhow. In memories, those 7 days in May. Nothing to choose. No country, no race ribbons, just some old white fluff stuff. And for some of us boys, well, it wasn't good enough. And in a Mount Vernon basement, in Guardiac's old house, well, it was Greg, Ted, and Pete, and we was churning them out. And it was country, it was country, and it was country again. And Sister Susan just loved what the neighbors came to stay. Singing Sawmill River Road, Sawmill River Road. It's a stop off in Ardsley, just east of the Parkway. And Sawmill River Road, feed the rebel in you. You take your 56 Chevy to that old chat and chew. Well, I talk of weeping willow,
but the tears I cried for that woman are gonna flood your big river, and I'm gonna sit right here until I die. It's a stop off in Ardsley, just east of the Parkway. And Sawmill River Road feed the rebel in. You take your 56 Chevy to that old chat. Was the Hudson Valley Boys on a good Friday night singing, do what you did, what you done me last night. And the neighbors, they got angry, and the police, they came around. You keep playing that song, boys, and we'll be shutting down. Singing Sawmill River Road, Sawmill River Road. It's a stop off in Ardsley, just east of the Parkway. And Sawmill River Road, be the rebel in you. You take your 56 Chevy, that old chant you. And upon other occasions, Joe would call me up on the stage and say, he said, get up here, JW, come on up here and sing that sexy one tonight. And so I used to get up and sing this one. Well, it seems kind of almost like a sacrilege to do 1/8 of Johnny Cash's Big River, so let's do the rest. Well, I taught the weeping willow and I cried, and I showed the clouds and cover of that clear blue sky, but the tears I cried for that woman, we're gonna flood you big river, and I'm gonna sit right here until I die. Well, I met her accidentally, St. Paul, Minnesota, and it tore me up every time I heard her call that southern drawl.
took me to St. Louis, later on down the river, and a freighter said she'd been in, but she gone, boy, she gone. Picked up her trail in Memphis, but she just walked up the bluff. She raised a few eyebrows and then she went on down the road. Patty on down the Baccaroos River Queen, roll it on. Oh, won't you take that woman on down to New Orleans? New Orleans, go on, I've had enough of my blues, down you go. Ah, she loves you, big river boy, hey. On time, it's the Hudson River line. God bless America in that charcoal sky. Boys, this is Harry. He's the conductor for the Putnam Division. And he's been doing it for 18 years, and he's been your daddy's friend for 9. And Harry, this is Barry, middle son John, and little Jane. Trying to teach my boys about that charcoal sky. Since the 1860s, boys, we've been pushing up steam. And you know I still hear those wheels every time I close my eyes. And without that steam, boys, there'd be no American dream. Daddy said, God bless you, Harry. It's the Hudson River line. I say goodbye to Harry, boys. The caboose, well, she's rolling. I watch him running to catch up to her. When he hops on board, boys, give a wave. Time we started going. Soon around that bend, we'll see that charcoal sky. Got a reservation down in Neverhand Station. Flatten your nickels, boys, and it's the Hudson River line. God bless America in that charcoal sky. This is the way it goes. I had the engineer get ready for me. I said, turn the lights out as soon as I walk in and put the thing in record, because I didn't want anybody to see me singing this song. Your solo, you ready? This is your therapy solo. Your wild thing. You don't sound too enthusiastic. Well, that's the way you have to start with this thing. You have to be a little nervous that you're afraid to do it. Sing one chorus so that the person next to you who you've known for a month or 5 years or 20 or 30 years or 40 or whatever, that when you sing this chorus, a wild thing, that that person has no idea who the hell you are. If you do it like that, you know, then you really got therapy. It's like, what? I don't care. Here, this is it. So the next time you have an argument with your boss or something like that, you say, excuse me, I'm going to go outside for therapy. Sing one chorus a while. I say, yes, can I help you now? All right, you ready for one good chorus?
Yeah.
This is my therapy every night. You know. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Wild Sage.
I'm stopping you not because you weren't very good. You actually were the best of any chorus we had. I'm just complimenting. Here we go. 2, 3, 4.
Wild Things! You make my heart sing.
It's too much like a choir. It's too perfect. We have to get it so that it's... Oh. Okay, one more. Here we go. 2, 3, 4.
Wild Things! You make my heart sing. You make everything.
Well, I don't want to thank you. Really, that was one of the best choruses we had, but one of the worst groovies. But nobody knows where to put groovy, including me, so don't feel bad. So let's do it one more time together. Here we go. 2, 3. There's rights and wrongs and fighting songs on both sides, and each day finds me changing points of view. And one says you've got to hurt to know the feeling, and another's fighting feelings to get through. And I am tired of hearing that same old story about where you gotta stand to feel your pain. These days it's hard to find a hero to help us helpless fools out of the rain. And my daddy was a golf pro up in Scarsdale, New York, and he worked his tail off 6 days a week. And he can't plant no taters with your golf club, but them city boys would listen when he'd speak. I am tired of hearing that same old story about where you gotta stand to feel your pain. And there's a truck stop on the wrong side of glory, and it's filled with fools waiting for a train. Thank you. some cowboy singing about his Indians. Free war, free poor, pretty faded jeans. Like he thinks there's a chance we wouldn't win again. If the whole world understood this song he sang. The troops have all withdrawn from Southeast Asia. And the Swiss banks got the bullion left by Chu. And we have rescued every blessed soul received. We'll adopt the ones that look like me and you. Don't and do so much of those that do, and goddamn the ones that keep this world insane. This before 9/11. A lot of people came out about 3 weeks before 9/11. It was a ray of light. It was a wall of sound. It was a fight. Until the walls came down, it was a dream to dream in any dead old town. It was a true America, red, white, black and blue America. Jack, you got balls of steel round that old racetrack. Didn't you spend them years? It was a march with Martin, 'cause that's just the way it feels. It was a true America, red, white, black and blue America. Back in the 1956, hallelujah, we were so bright. Nobody could tell us, I forgot. Elvis Presley, 1956, on Earth. How can you sing to get her off my mind? Back in the 1966, wasn't it everything to you? Didn't the passion fit the song? Here we are. Where's that good old tune? Where's that dream to dream? Where's that man on the moon? All the heroes came, but they were gone so soon. Martin Luther King, and he says, I've gone up on the mountain, and I have seen the other side, and I am happy tonight. Oh, I'm not worried about anything.
Son, Holy Ghost said, no, don't you dare.
Dutchman blues again. It's wildflowers in the spring, sha-la-la. Takes me back to the Irish bars and in Mount Vernon, where I played when I was signed to King Records, just before I got signed. And I had my humble band, the Town and Country Brothers, and wonderful guys. All right, Lapke, this will sing this for you and wish you a very happy birthday. Wonderful, this was wonderful. All right, thanks everybody. Here we go. Steel player Jimmy got his fiddle making like it was his own world. I got some city hillbillies, some green-eyed fillies looking up at me like I was Merle. And if we can't fool them all the time, it's all right with me. It's still my song, ain't nothing wrong. Wasn't born in Tennessee. I was 7 and 10 years and hiding my beard behind the sound of a steel guitar. Though the city was rocking, we was country, socking it to him at a Mount Vernon bar. So us Smith City folks doing our strokes, that don't qualify me. Well, I'm back again, you remember then. Wasn't born in Tennessee, singing for Merle, here we go. We don't smoke marijuana in Muskogee, no. We don't take our trips on LSD. San Fran hippies and L.A. hippies ain't changing that old enough. joint trying to get these words to rhyme. It'll be my pride if I can hide my side of the Mason-Dixon line. But if that don't play your party, honey, it's alright with me. Cause I got my dream waiting just upstream. I wasn't born in Tennessee, yeah. Got my full pedal steel player, Jimmy got his fiddle hanging like it was his own world. I got Sandy Hill Billy's green light belts looking up at me like I was Merlin. If we can't fool them all the time, it's alright with me. Cause it's still my song, ain't nothing wrong. Wasn't born on a farm, on a farm. I never knew a horse and didn't wager on. I wasn't born in Tennessee. Just a drifter from Charlotte who settled in New York. Nobody knows why John calls this place home. Oh, but three nights a week he could always be found listening to my music and drinking them down. And one night I asked him what his day job could be, and he sidestepped the question and he asked about me. Oh, but sometimes at night, with a suitcase in hand, you can't tell if he's going or if he's already been. And we play soft and loud to the likes of the crowd. Keep the bar room as deep as we can. It just ain't the same if he ain't in the game. And John Tucker is on the wagon again. John spoke of a lady from some other day who sat down beside him and just a little something to say. Though she left him no number and little was said, still her soft smile in the music would big John in bed. Then we play soft the loud to the likes of the crowd. Keep the bar room as deep as we can. Oh, but it just ain't the same. He ain't in the game. John Tucker, he's on the wagon again. Mm-hmm. something just to keep the songs flowing. Well, I'd look to that corner where old John did stand, and I would sing to that vision of old Big John saying, he smiled on his face and drank his hand. Then we play soft and loud to the likes of the crowd. Keep the barroom as deep as we can. It just ain't the same if he ain't in the game. And John Tucker is on the wagon again. Definitely leave you with this one. But don't, you can't leave now because I stay, because I want to meet every one of you. Who's that man in the mirror by the bar? Looking ugly and older than his shadows and his scars. He ain't closed his eyes in 2 days, maybe three. Holy shit, John. It's me. Had a friend named Jesus back in 1965. Oh, but that son of a bitch, well, he stole three chords just to keep his dreams alive. But who just found them missing years and set that damn fool free? Holy shit, it is me. Sing it with me, holy shit. Holy shit, that's great. This is it. If you don't stand for nothing, girls, you might as well just quit. Mary, Mary. Mary, Mary, don't you think that's kind of scary? Bring on the Holy Ghost and let's all drink a toast. Holy shit. Smoky subway room, and he's mixing the dead with Radiohead, with Beck and the Rolling Stones, while some fool's rolling snake eyes now is looking for a four and a three. Holy shit, it is me. Here we go. Holy shit. Holy shit. Oh, this is it. This is it. If you don't stand for nothing, boys, might as well just quit. Mary, Mary. Mary, Mary, don't you think that's kind of scary? Bring on the Holy Ghost. Let's all drink a toast. I've seen those eyes before. I've had that scared look on my face when I watched the world turn inside out when I stood in just one place. Oh, but who jumped in the firing line? Is this just what he had to do? shit.
It's you. It's you and you and you. And I know you. I've seen you. Oh, two, three, four.
Holy shit.
This is it. This is it. Oh, yes. If you don't stand for nothing, boys and girls, you might as well just quit. Mary, Mary. Mary, Mary. Don't you think that's kind of scary? Ring on. I was just thinking about the first time I played this song was in New York, and we were going up to Boston to play it. We played it at the Bottom Line Club in New York, and the girl came up to Boston to show up, and she said, "I was there yesterday, Chip. Would you play that song you sang yesterday?" I said, "What song is that, Michelle?" She said, "Holy shit." I said, "I don't know, Michelle, you know, if I can do it tonight." We were playing in a church. And we were on the altar. That was the stage, was the altar. Jesus behind us and the priest right over there. And all throughout the show, I kept thinking to myself, am I going to do it? Do I have the courage to sing this song here tonight? And I went down. I didn't do it. I had a nice show and everything, but that was on my mind from the beginning, and it bothered me that I didn't do it. You know, like I sang that song for you before, you know? Once I mentioned that song for you, the new song, if I didn't sing it, that would have bothered me all night tonight that I didn't play it for you. So I got that off my chest. But this night, I was really upset. The show was over. I went downstairs. Then I hear noise going on up there. And the guy comes out, she said, "Chip, they won't leave. They want you to do another song." I said, "Oh, okay." "This is it. I'm getting one more chance." I said, "All right." So when I went on stage, I saw the priest there, and I said, "Oh, thanks so much." And I said, "I'm just going to leave you with a little chorus and I'll play you a little bit of this song, and then we'll say goodbye." And I got off the microphone, you know, And I started to sing it off microphone, and I was singing it pretty loud, you know. "Who's that man in the mirror by the bar?" And when I got to "Holy shit," the priest didn't look like this. And I started to sing it, and what happened was the people that were in the back of the church, when I got off mic, they couldn't hear me so good, you know. So when I was singing, "Who's that man in the mirror by the bar?" And they're leaning on the kneelers. So they're leaning forward like this. So we got time when it came to the chorus, and I just kept going a little bit. And by the time I got to the second chorus, they were all kneeling and singing, "Holy shit." And this priest, I don't think, ever saw such reverence in his church in a while. You know? So I kept going, and we finished the song. And by the end of the chorus, I kept looking over at the priest. And I don't think he was too happy with me. A couple of things I said earlier, a mild thing and all this. But he started singing along the chorus in the last chorus. I was so happy. He was singing, "Holy shit," everybody was singing. So here, for that brave priest, and you know, this is a wonderful night tonight. I had such a wonderful time tonight. So thank you all so much. And let's sing one chorus of "Holy shit," and then I'll see you in a second here. Is there a bar in the back there? "Holy shit, I want to toast you." 2, 3, here we go. 4. "Holy shit, this is it. This is it. If you don't stand for nothing, boys and girls, might as well just quit, that's true. Mary, Mary. Mary, Mary. Don't you think that's kind of scary? Oh, bring on the Holy Ghost. He's here tonight. I know he's. He's liking the show. He's singing the song with him. Bring on the Holy Ghost and let's all drink a toast. 1, 2, 3.
Holy shit.
God bless you guys. Thanks so much for a great night. John, please.